Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the Super Deformed LegendBB Mark III Daishogun. So this is the... I know the one Daishogun, but was there a second one? Like, for this to be warranted as Mark III, I don't know. Yeah, this is the unarmored mode, or they call it, light armor type. Okay, nice to be able to read it in the instructions. Pretty basic. You have the switchable eye gimmick, like the others have. And you have the normal eyes, looking to the left, looking to the right. But these ones are new. They're kind of like glossy, because he is crying. Yeah. I was trying to figure out why these stickers weren't lining up with the lines in the face message, because they're tears running down his face. It's actually in the instructions there, in the little comic strip. He does an attack on this monster thingies, and then the power, like this Phoenix Force thing, I guess that gave him the power here, is leaving, and he's crying. I've never seen that before. I don't think I have a Gundam that he cries, but yeah, there we go. First time for everything. Other stickers, the ones around the wrists, and that's it. He does look a little weird with just the black on the legs, but that will work later on. Articulation-wise, double ball-jointed neck, ball-jointed shoulder, the ball-jointed polycap in the torso you can bring forward, ball-jointed arm, hinge elbow, ball-jointed wrist, ball-jointed waist, legs, and feet. So standard. And now, turning him into the first armor set, which is the Mark III in armor, okay, we have these parts right here. So, let's start putting them on. I've already done this video once, but I think I can make it a little faster. It was pretty long. It was pretty time-consuming, but I think I have it down now. I say that. No, it gives you a crap ton of black, which I really like. Compared to the next mode, which gives you more white and red, and a little bit of black. I also like this gold. Very nice and shiny. A little sparkly. And the backpack. This backpack looks familiar. Kind of looks like from the Astray M1. That's the way it looks, but I know it's not for that. Oh, and also get on there, shoulder armor. I don't want to clip it on too hard because it'll be a pain in the butt to get off. But the shoulder arm, or the backpack, this, it goes in at an angle. Don't try to get it flush, you'll just wreck it. So it just goes in like that. So, shoulder armor fell off. Oh, you're gonna make it a pain, aren't you? Polycap ball joints, and then really cool helmet. I do like that. So, there he is with all the armor. I think looking pretty good. The, all the gold, that cool crescent moon beef in. I got a sticker on the forehead, some red on the chest, red and gold on the crotch. And, that's about it for stickers. So, not a whole bunch. And the articulation is pretty much the same, because these got out of the way, and nothing's really hindered. I think it looks pretty good. Now, in terms of accessories for this mode, at least, you do get the stick, and kind of like a trident, I guess. More of that nice gold. And he will hold it nicely. Like that. I think this is my favorite form of the three. Because from here on out, it just gets crazy. Crazy bread. So you pretty much have to take off everything you just put on. And doing this a lot is really, I think, it really does a job on the polycaps and their connection. So, yeah, I don't think I'd recommend doing it a lot. And there are, unfortunately, nothing you do here you keep on. So, You got a lot of parts left over that you gotta kind of keep track of. Which, I kind of wish that at least some of the parts stayed on. Oh, well. So, let's start doing it. We got a front skirt, the back skirt, which kind of looks like the cubulet, somewhat. The feet are weird because you have to actually take them off. And you have these kind of like toe extensions that slide on right there. And then you got some, I guess, ankle armor? So you can see the difference there. Whatever. That'll work. Same thing on this side. Trying to get this all done. I always try in a hurry sometimes, but that's just going to make it harder. And I'll just end up falling, having them fall apart. Eh. Like that. And it's also hot in here. Get on there. Come on. There we go. Alright, so shoulder armor wise, pretty bulky, pretty detailed. I like that the gold here is a separate piece that goes in the black. And you do have to kind of hold it together, because since it's separated here in the center, and if you try and put it in here, if you don't push it together, it won't clip. And even if it does clip, it might actually separate anyway, so let's hope it doesn't. So we don't have to keep doing that. And also, these are kind of heavy, so there's a good chance that the arms will fall off. Anybody knows there's one spike here? This is for later. Alright, so let's continue. Here's the cool chest armor. Goes right on there. And we got giant backpack, which you have to use an adapter piece. You just peg that in, which will allow you to connect the backpack, like so. And, oh, I just noticed those are the same. There we go. That looks better. And then the really, really cool looking helmet. I do like the helmet. Very decorative. What the hell fell off? Oh, why is this one falling off all the time? It was okay before. Now it's not. So that is the, I guess I call it the Daishogun? Yeah? I'm gonna say yes. So, yeah. Very ornamental. Very heavy in the back. Can't really get those cannons that far forward. I don't know if it's supposed to be the double axe. It kind of looks like it. And I love these parts here. They've actually done a really cool job making the thin armor actually, like the pieces clipped together. Little slits right in there. And it just makes these small, thin pieces actually hold. So you have multiple colors. Very cool. Sticker-wise, you got the eyes on the forehead here, and on the green here on the shoulders. You got silver underneath the clear jewel, some gold, some silver. You got this really awesome jewel in the chest, which is a bubble. Gold wrapped around that. Sticker on top of that, gold and white. Some on the sides. Got red and gold on the crotch, a little bit of red here, and red on the, or sorry, gold on the toes. And that's pretty much it. Oh, and also there's one for the new camera, too. Oh, and also gold on the helmet here. So yeah, it is okay, it is quite a bit. Now you can also take out the helmet and give him a battle mask, which has red for stickers. Little holes in the side of the cheeks there. And you have that. Now you also have a katana, because what Musha would be complete without that? Little sticker there, the other side is hollow. And it will peg onto the side skirt. Like that. Whoops. Now you also have a couple of things. You have these, which he can totally hold separately, or you can take this connector and have them combined. And you can take these bird heads for whatever friggin' reason, and you can peg them onto the ends of the weapons. I don't really understand why, but you can totally do it. Okay, why not? So, that is pretty much it, I'd say, for this mode, and it is rather bulky and hard to move without parts coming off, at least on mine, and helmet is and the shoulders are kind of limited in articulation. The lower half's not too bad. But the back, you can see, is very heavy too, so, yeah. Now, the final mode is, I am not kidding when I say it is called the Dragon Horse Phoenix Form. Yeah. At least that's the way it's translated into. And yeah, it is. So first we can take the helmet and bring it down to cover its eyes because, I guess, I don't know. Why not? We'll take off the feet, but we have to take these off, and we need to keep the ball joints in there, which can be a trouble sometimes. Just gotta wiggle them out like that. Okay, now what we're gonna do is replace the humanoid feet with these kind of like griffin feet. And those get these as kind of like knee spikes. And they'll just slide onto the ball joints. That makes them easy to go on, but then it also makes them easy to come off. So, you win some, you lose some. And hopefully my camera will last. I tried to charge it, and it was taking too long, so whatever. Now I'm taking the backpack off. Whatever. Keep your head off. This part here, that little adapter that connected it, we're going to use that. And actually separate half of the cannon. Come on. And this stores the hind legs for the new mode. And you get new... I guess these are the, what was it? Horse mode? Dragon mode? I don't know. It's all kind of weird. But, get those out. And then with some black ball joint poly caps, just for this mode, gonna get that adapter piece with this plug here in the back. Peg them in so they have hind legs. And then we can take the back skirt and peg it into there. So now he kind of has a tail. And then taking what's left of the backpack, you're going to rotate it so that this peg is now facing back. And then peg that into the back, like that. And then peg this. Unfortunately, from doing this basket in here, I think it's actually stressed the hole, and now this part here doesn't fit. It fits, it doesn't hold, though, as well as I'd like. Hopefully it'll make me a liar, because that would be nice. So it'll stay together. And finally, let's get the head on. Head on. Oh, no, it's still doing it. But that is essentially the horse dragon phoenix mode. That is the thing. That is ridiculous. It's kind of cool, but it's also insane. There's too much going on here. There's too many pegging and ball joints and stuff, and they're not meant for all this weight that it now has, because it is kind of like heavy in terms of like the back, the shoulders, the head, the ass. So, yeah, kind of weird. Now, another weapon you can use, which I like to use in this mode, take this without without that, and that one spike on the shoulder will go onto there. I can still have the katana on, but I'm not going to, because it's just something else that gets knocked off. get it there. Okay, so that's pretty much it. That is ridiculous. Actually, let me go grab some of the other BB Legend kits. Well, I think this is probably the best comparison, the Night Gundam, because it does have a Centaur mode. And then how about the Superior Night Dragon, I think it is? Oh, I love this one. That friggin' chrome. And compared to a EX Standard Exia. Yeah, this thing's pretty big now. But it's definitely not my favorite. It's actually probably near the bottom of the BB Legend kits for me, just because my favorite mode is the first armor mode. It's not overly complicated, and it looks good. And anything after that, personally, is way too busy. And way too heavy, way too cluttered. But it is kind of neat. I'll admit that. This horse, phoenix, dragon thing. So, that is about it, and I'll see you in the next review.